Welcome back to our video series of What is a Disciple? We have been reviewing the definition of a disciple, which is one who follows Christ, one who grows in Christ, one who serves in Christ, and one who shares in Christ. And I think if you talk to most Christians, they would all, for the most part, agree that the most difficult part of the definition of a disciple is sharing in Christ. There are pretty much four common barriers. Now, I will say self-imposed barriers, but there's four barriers that pretty much explains the majority of our hesitation, our anxiety, or even fear of rejection when it comes to sharing the gospel, the good news of God. The first one is, what if they ask questions I cannot answer? Number two, I struggle with my own faith. How am I supposed to share my faith with others? Number three, I never learned how to share the gospel with others. And number four, I don't even know how to start the conversation. Again, these are four barriers that are very common, but they are self-imposed. And I emphasize the word self-imposed, but I'd like to maybe make this more palatable or maybe a little bit easier for you to approach sharing Christ. Unlike what we are used to in society and our culture from the day we're born, that life is about accomplishments, it's about results, it's about our outcomes from the energies and efforts we put into it. The gospel and the sharing of the gospel is not the same. See, you are not, and I want you to hear this, you are not responsible for the outcomes or the results of sharing the gospel. See, that's not for you to take ownership of, because it's not you doing the work, it's not you doing the transforming, it's not even you doing the convincing or the convicting. That's the role of the Holy Spirit. We are simply to be a willing vessel to share God's good news. Another way of explaining this, I just came across this quote when I was reading through one of Henry Nouwen's books. I think he says it very eloquently. He says, "We are not the healers, we are not the reconcilers, we are not the givers of life. We are sinful, broken, vulnerable people who need as much care as anyone we care for. The mystery of ministry is that we have been chosen to make our own limited and very conditional love," and here's the key word, "the gateway for the unlimited and unconditional love of God." See, as I said, we're just supposed to be willing vessels or the gateway for the Holy Spirit to work through. We've talked about it before, the difference between trying and relying. The Holy Spirit is not expecting us to try to do the convincing or the convicting. That's not our role. We're simply to rely on God, rely on the Holy Spirit to handle the delivery and the understanding and the interpretation of us sharing the gospel. I love pulling evidence out through scripture, and I think Paul explains this very well and why we should feel more comfortable in sharing the good news with others. Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, he says, "We are ambassadors for Christ." In other words, we're just representatives. We're just deliverers of information. "As though God were making an appeal through us, we beg you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God." See, this is a message of a loving and pursuing God. He is having us to make an appeal, and he's doing it through us, and he's asking us to beg on God's behalf or on Christ's behalf that you be reconciled with God so that you can be part of the Christian family. I hope you've enjoyed this video series on what is a disciple. If you have any additional further questions, as it says in the scripture that we read today, I appeal to you to reach out to your pastor. I appeal to you to reach out to leaders in your church. Or if you don't have somebody you can reach out to, my information is given at the end of this video. I would be honored to come alongside of you and walk with you on your path of discipleship.